Greetings, Internet. My name is Special Spaceman, and this is Purple Spacebag Program, New Horizons Mod, Episode 2. It's been a long time since I've been recording. Sorry about that. And to start off this episode, I have a ship prepared. If you didn't catch the last episode, there might be a link in the description or somewhere in the video. Somewhere. Here we go. Well, basically, we just launched our space program with the Quick Thunder, with Valkyrian's Kitten and Quick Thunder. One was just a little ship to get some quick science, and the other was trying to get to the Demonstration Center from the BB, which was unsuccessful. So, we'll start with KSS Chariot. This rocket is designed to go to high atmosphere, even maybe break to outer space as itself. It's going by Bill Kerman, because I have plans for Gemini and Valentina soon. And let's see the science capabilities. Well, there's more form fitting factor thanks to the universal storage mod. There's two goo containers, like the last one, but more uniform here and here. And inside the science bay, open doors right here, is a thermometer. And a barometer. Yeah, it's right here. Barometer. Those doors. Alright. And basically, same mission as last time. We're going to strap a booster. Saw fuel booster. Yeah. SRB. Yeah. With 200 kilonewtons of thrust into the air, and we're gonna separate and land back down. That's basically it. So with the same mission plan, let's save and launch. All right, since now we're on the launch pad, let me just get this and just doing some pinning. Make sure. Launch! But that's not reusable at all. So, what's that periapsis looking like? Oh, we're hitting periapsis already. All right, cool. Log temperature data. Temperature's the average. Open day doors. Temperature data. No, pressure data. Reading seem nominal, snack time. Ooh. Observe mystery goods. Yeah, I'm not expecting that much at this point. Alright. Now we're going down. We haven't hit the main atmosphere yet. So I'm gonna see you when we
I am my foot.
Now we're just waiting. Well, shout out. Black spec there. And now we're just waiting for it to deploy. But wait, Starcraft? Well, maybe we'll go test this. Alright, now we're just waiting for us to hit the ground. See ya then! And we're stable there, so let's get some science. Be very important, so nibbles on your foot. Our mateys, let's show those land lubbers at the KSC who the masters of high seas truly are. Okay. He thinks he's a pirate now, and let's do that fine. Who report? Wrong one. Sorry about that. Sir, Mr. Crew. The crew is freshly hydrated and starts to dissolve. Okay. And since I call that success for science, let's recover the vessel. And we got a total of 36.6 science from that. 36 science. And Xerox speed game. Okay. Bill Kerman has these medals. Researching Tower Science. Landing EVA in Kerbin's water. Splashdown. Landing on Kerbin. Standing 6 Gs for 3 more seconds. 10 kilometers at 50 KC. Acquiring horizontal Mach run. Below 30,000 meters, reaching an altitude above 1,000 meters, reaching any speed greater than 100 meters per second, and launching with soft booster with 20% at 20% of the ship's mass. Alright, let's do some science then. Alright, we definitely need the rockets. Can we research any of those? No. Alright. And you might be wondering why we need the rockets. Well, here we go. Well, it's because if we need to go any further, we need actual liquid fuel. I mean, you can do it with solid boosters, but if you want to go further, you need to use liquid fuel as a way. So. That's why I was saving Jebediah. Yeah, so new specials now have Jebediah, and we're going to keep the same size as the rest. But this time... Thank you. We didn't research that, so... Casey Chariot to... KSS, while we think of warm workers, broken speed record 250 meters, altitude record 7,000 meters, and land distance of 10K. Alright. Okay, hold on, let me first do my staging. That launched Mercury in suborbital trajectory missions. It's the same rocket Alan Shepard used to become the first American to go into space. So yeah, fitting. Alright. And Jeb's in there, yes. Save. Oh, and also there's down. Obadiah might not survive from this. Hopefully he could, but... Alright. Separation of second stage is... nominal in 3, 2, 1. Alright, we have separated, and we're 60 kilometers and still climbing. Okay. What I might do is, you might see, oh, hey look, that's Valentine, I think. I need to go to the map section. This is one of the mods I added, which adds a second star to Kerman, but it's really far away, but still bright. And we have break in the atmosphere. Yay. Alright. For report. Hey, I can see Jeb's eagle from here. Well, you are Jeb, but... however. It's supposed to be someone else. Alright. Where's the second container? Observe mystery goop. You hope the tax page won't find out how much observing the goop in space costs. Well, not that much, actually. To be fair, but to actually send it up, I mean, not the average, whatever. Well, I space, which I could hear is from freezing cold to freezing hot, depending on how close to the sun you are. Instrument reads here as if we're in a vacuum. 4.8 seconds. Alright, I'm gonna read this after the mission is successful. And we're about to hit periapsis pretty soon. Once we hit 92 kilometers. Oh, if you might hear that in the audio. Sorry about that. So yeah. All our experience is done, and all I have to do is send in this, and just wait for time warp.
I got
to
get the
what we need to do is spin, because we're going near orbital velocity and entering the atmosphere, but I'm not sure if we have we're going to have enough angle to... okay. How much? Okay, we do have a little bit left. Some of it left. Well, okay. Okay. The idea is, when you start spinning, you dissipate heat and separates throughout all the experiments and stuff like that. And you're wondering why I didn't do an EVA, because I need to upgrade the astronaut complex to do the said EVA power. It will be great. A great amount of science we can achieve when doing that. But that's the next mission. And since now we're heating up, you're asking, wait a minute, why aren't you closing your experiments? Well, that actually is to create drag and to slow down the craft even more. Okay. And now we're violently spinning. Okay, spin. Jeb might like this. Spin. Okay. Things might blow up. Wolf is not the parachute. Okay. 3,000. 2,000. 2,000. 1,000. And mission successful. Yeah, we just survived at re-entering the atmosphere without a heat shield. Oh, and by the way, that ring is the new planet. I forgot the name. We're going to go into the cactus mission after this. After a successful mission to explore the rest of the planets that's around the solar system. The New Horizons project. This is the main mod that basically changes the solar system as a whole and gives us a bunch of new planets to visit. And I believe this is a good... we're in the water again. Cool. Oh, 21 science, 0.6 science for Earn, and 53 science in total. We have. Alright. And here's what Jeb has earned. Research Ribbon 1. War for 10 more research. Splashdown. Landing on Kerbin. We're staying 4Gs in 3 more seconds. Flying horizontally at Mach 2 below 30,000 meters. Significant contract completed. First Kerbal in space. Distant record at RIP. Okay, more than 10k. Any speed rise greater than 100 meters per second. And altitude above 1,000 meters. 10% of the ship mass was the solid fuel. Alright, cool. And research and development. We get stability. And we can't research any of these yet. So, yeah. And we have 166,000 Kirk bucks now. We could go for more rockets. That's gives us like more engines and fuels. General construction, that gives us, yeah, that's supposed to build like airships and more decouplers. And oh, we get the ground pilot, which is actually aviation. That's more planes. And for fairings, actually. Huh. And we have stability, which gives us... Oh, ooh, the new command pod. The two-person command pod. The Corvus command pod. And the Nemus Cone. Era. Ooh. I guess it's MRC guided. Yeah, and also... I think this might be... Alright. And it gives some S. Enhanced survivability, safety lights, radial airbags, we get airbags, and escape pods, oh, ooh, solar panels, service ring, storage box, supply bag, yeah, this is the escape pad, escape pods, and for science, we get a bunch of science, capacitor, discharge capacitor through a solely, go soul to charge up when it's triggered, it'll rapidly deposit its store charge into your electric banks. Procedural battery, battery packs, and probes! Cool. Scale up storage for units. Science Junior. So. And we get high gain tennis. Yay. I am using the community tech tree right now. And get a new solar system on. And it gives us like new science stuff. QLB air drives to reach that new solar system I was talking about. Stuff like that. But we're in the beginnings. So. Alright. Yeah. I was just showing you last time. We're actually opening a planet called. Click on it. Sona. Yeah, I was right. With the moon. Operator,
Sarah. Just look at Sarah. Like other bodies orbiting us. They even, may even have atmospheres. See. Spinning of Sarah was once home to more plentiful environment than see today. Even with this breathable atmosphere still prevalent on this moon, it's hard to imagine vibrant and colorful this world used to be while staring at its cold, lifeless surface. So yeah, this actually has an atmosphere. Cool. So, this is the new solar system. Let me zoom out. Yeah, small hole's now a moon with a planet called Mole. I think it's a gas giant. Yeah, right here. Now Sol, planet on the sun, Uranus, is actually closer than Mole. So I believe I need to check the base game again. Alright, then we have Eve, which is alone now. Gilly's no longer orbiting it. Like, Venus is smart equivalent to Venus. Then we have Lathe, which is our Earth, which is this one's Earth now, with Dresto as its moon. Yeah, and Sonos or like Mars. Then we get to Jewel, which, interesting enough, has Dres, which is Dres and Duma orbiting it, along with Leosh, is this weird crater moon, and Nolas, with more weird crater moon, Duna, and Ike, actually, Duna, Duna's actual moon is now orbiting Jewel, so yeah. Titanus is moving to our Saturn with its rings with Tylo, Aurea, and Aurea. And Elu. And now Elu has a moon now, and it's Minmus. And in the base game, Minmus actually orbits Kerbin, and a bunch of guys suggest you go to Minmus first because the soul, gravity's so low there that could basically extremely hard to not slow. It doesn't require that much delta V more than going to the moon, but it advantage that it has lower gravity, so you don't need as much delta V to get on the ground and get off and go back to Kerbin. Gilly's move to Vador, along with Titus, Paul, Tala, Val, Bop, and Gilly's, that's what Gilly's for. And that would be the outer solar system, if not for... Valentine. Yes, I was correct with Valentine. With this cool new planet. Meter. Heba. I'll show you. With the Sarek. And all this cool stuff, but we won't be touching this for a long while to very late game into the series because, well, it's extremely far away. I heard people say with all Interstellar installed, it took them like 10 in-game years to get there, which technically makes sense if it's going like a light year per sec. 10 in-game years, not like fully 10 years exactly. Yeah, Robert, I'm just rambling at this point. So yeah, the New Horizons one. This has been Retro Spaceman. If you like this content, please subscribe, leave your like. If you didn't like this content, please leave a dislike. And if you have anything to say on improvements on the series and stuff, leave a comment down below. This has been Retro Spaceman, and I hopefully see you in the next episode when that comes out.